I've had a really diverse career, and that's been a bit of a blessing and a curse. I think, starting in Rent, I knew that I could sing, and I knew I could sort of captivate an audience on a Broadway stage. I knew what that felt like. I knew how to do it. I knew how it technically went. I knew that's fine. I trusted myself in that arena. The moment where I felt truly validated as an actor, like, whoa, was I did a play at Lincoln Center opposite Hope Davis called Spinning Into Butter, which was about racism on a college campus. And it was the first time, and Daniel Sullivan directed it, who's like a multi-Tony Award-winning director. And it was a play, no music. And it was the first time I was like, oh my God, I was 20, about to be 21. And I was like, oh my gosh, no, I think this is, because Rent was one of those shows where if you were the right skin color, you looked right, you sang it, they were kind of likely to hire you at some point. And so I kept telling myself that I got on the show, oh no, because you look like him, or because you're perfect for this, for this one niche thing, but that doesn't mean you're an actor. And Spinning Into Butter kind of really gave me that. But then Queer Eye came along. And I took Queer Eye because it was on a small cable station that very few people watched. Inside the Actors Studio, I think, was their big money maker at the time, and not much else. And so I thought, no one will see it. And so I took it as supplementary income. I did Queer Eye during the day, Xanadont at night, for 2 months until I realized, oh my God, I can't, this is not sustainable. So I was put in my 2 weeks notice at Xanadont, and they were like, well, if you're leaving, we're closing the show. So then the show closed. Queer Eye debuted and became this thing, and suddenly the world got to know me as this cultural savant, of which at that moment I didn't really ever want to be. And so there was a sense of responsibility to now give the world what they were asking for and not denounce the show and say, no, just kidding, guys, I'm an actor, because it would put in jeopardy the authenticity of the other cast members. Well, if he's acting, everyone else must be. So I had to keep a tight lip on the performing thing, which really sucked, because I remember there being times on Queer Eye, actually after season one, the producers met with us, and they were just telling us about, this is going to be, the train is moving, guys. This is what needs to happen. These are what we're going to be doing. It's going to be, if anyone needs to or wants to get off this moving train, now's the time to speak up. And everything within me was like, my heart was racing, my ears were red, and I remember thinking, you want to quit. This is not for you. You're not happy. This isn't, you're sitting across from Oprah and Ellen and lying to them about, or pretending to be this person that you don't feel you are. I didn't feel like the Puerto Rican Emily Post. I didn't. And so it was tricky. And so I sat and I pushed through. And the minute I moved to LA, I was like, okay, I'm just gonna get back to acting and performing. And it took like a year of living here to get a role. And for someone who had been so fortunate to first audition out of high school, Rent, boom, booked it. First soap audition, boom, booked it. So first movie, booked it. First commercial, booked it. To suddenly be auditioning regularly and not booking was like profoundly like, whoa. And when I did my first couple of guest stars, thank you, Ryan Murphy, for putting me on Nip Tuck. I started gaining a little more self-confidence and realizing, oh my gosh, there's ebbs and flows in this business. I'm not going to be working every single day. Like, I might have gaps in employment. And what's that going to look like? How does that affect me mentally? You start doubting your skill set. And then you realize it's the nature of the business when you're in a room auditioning for the same role as someone you've watched for decades on television, and they're auditioning for the same part you are. It kind of equalizes it all, and it takes away a bit of the anxiety. I mean, I'm lucky to be able to host, act, sing, so I can keep myself busy between projects, thankfully. And I think that is kind of what's kept me mentally stable all these years.